Welcome back, everyone. This is PapaSean, and we are looking at ARK Survival Evolved, patch 236, that's targeted for February 15th, 2016. Today is January 31st, so getting very close, just a couple weeks to go. And what do we have to look forward to? Well, we've got a giant beaver, the first three bosses and boss arenas, so that would be the giant ape, the broodmother, and the dragon. And then we've got the snow and swamp caves, as well as server performance phase 2 and breeding mechanics phase 2. So let's go into those in a little bit more detail. So for the server performance phase 2, to me that just yells we'll be able to use lower end computers and be able to run the games nicely, or if we've got higher end computers it'll just be that much easier for our boxes to function. The server performance means you have more players on the servers with less lag and handling better on like the structures and things. It's just going to make everything in the game go so much better. So we're very happy and glad to hear about that. Breeding mechanics phase 2, not sure entirely what to expect here with the breeding mechanics. Probably some tweaks. We currently have the baby phase where there's high intensive care of these dinosaurs. And then you move into kind of an intermediate level where you have feeding troughs able to take a lot of the burden on. And then the final stage of it is just kind of that more of the same. It's just easier. The dinosaurs take longer to consume the food, and so it doesn't really seem to be too much difference between the second and third phase. First phase is just the really intense part. Once you punch through that, you're in the home stretch. So I'm wondering if they're going to modify the second and third phase to kind of distinguish them amongst each other. And then looking at the snow and swamp caves, for that it's just having more options available to us. I don't really know if they're going to open up new areas under, like in the snow or the swamp themselves. So if you've got a swamp and you go down into the swamp, where do you get water? So is it going to be an underwater cave system? We'll have to see how that goes. But definitely neat to have additional caves to explore. All right, and then let's circle back in here on the first three bosses and boss arenas. So I'll take a quick look at the broodmother that we've got here. Pretty scary alien looking. It's got some kind of hieroglyphic kind of alien talk, it looks like. So this brood mother, it's a great source of chitin right when you kill it. And they're also going to throw in the dragon that we have here. And the dragon's got some fire attacks, ability to fly. It's perma passive unless it's tamed by individual and that's riding it, at which point you can then control its attack. And then there's also the Megaphyticus, and this guy here, massive ape. He throws rocks, destroys structures, and can take out multiple dinosaurs in single, you know, rock throws and punches. Alright, so you've got the giant ape, the dragon, and the broodmother, and then you add them together in an arena. So what does that mean? My guess is you're going to be on one of these bad boys, and you're going to be fighting each other, so it's kind of a... I'm just assuming it's going to be a big mosh pit of bosses. So you'll either be riding on these, fighting each other, or you'll be playing as these. So let's see how that turns out in the next couple weeks. All right, and then finally up, we've got the giant beaver. So this I saved for last because this I believe to be an autonomous wood collector. All right, so when you're reading the dossier, it gives some hints towards the fact that it's going to be very extremely efficient at collecting wood. Well, you've got other dinosaurs that can do that, the mammoth. And they carry a lot of weight, right? You can even take a brontosaurus out there and tail swipe, you've got plenty of wood. So why would you want something like this? Well, it might be a smaller dinosaur for you, something you can have wander around your safer areas and collect wood for you, at which point you just go over to your beavers and take the wood off of them. Alright, so my expectation is that these will be autonomous wood collectors, very efficient at their jobs. You just set them to wander and they'll do their task. They're not going to have a lot of weight, so you're going to have to go over there and harvest off of the beavers. But take a pack of these into the woods and you know, set them to wander, and then when you're done, give them, you know, I don't know, 2 minutes, go AFK, get yourself a cup of tea, whistle, follow all, they all come back to you. Hopefully they haven't wandered too far in 2 minutes or so, but collected plenty of wood in the forest, and then you can have them follow you back to base, at which point you offload several hundred wood. Alright, so very industrious little buggers. At this point, I'll read through the dossier. So these guys are going to be herbivores. They're friendly. You won't have to worry about them attacking you, crazy beavers coming after you out of the water. So the beaver is a large mammalian herbivore that tends to live near water. Unlike other larger beaver species, this one retains the chisel-shaped teeth of modern beavers. As is typical for the beavers, they build dams as habitats, but the larger creatures on the island have a tendency to trample them. As a result, finding unsullied dams in the wild is quite rare. So you're not going to see any dams out there, you're just going to see the beavers wandering about. The beavers itself doesn't seem to realize how dangerous the island is. I don't know if it's simply too dumb to notice the dangers, or if it just doesn't care. But the beaver happily goes about its day playing in the water and gnawing on wood. Domesticated, the value of a tamed beaver is obvious from its physiology. The creature naturally gathers wood extremely efficiently, far more than most species on the island. It's not the strongest creature, so it can only carry limited amounts, but it is a natural lumberjack. Well, there you have it, the giant beaver, I believe to be autonomous wood collecting, and four checks on that wood, so you can, I'm thinking that you stick them on a tree, they're going to collect far more wood than you would with an axe. So get yourself a pack of beavers and get to work. Alright, well, thank you very much for watching. This is Papa Sean. Looking forward to the next patch of ARK Survival Evolved. Please mash that like button, subscribe, and share. These things help me out immensely. And if you do, they're free. If you do, you'll also have additional content made available to you, and you'll be notified when additional videos are released. Well, thank you very much for watching, and I'll catch you on the next one. Take care.